This is the introduction to the PerfectRAW mode of ColorPerfect. PerfectRAW is based on new technology that takes digital camera raw data and produces images with color integrity. That is, the color in the images is visually consistent, which is often not true of other methods. I have started the first step in the PerfectRAW process by dropping a folder of digital camera raw images onto the MakeTIFF window. MakeTIFF is downloaded and installed as part of the PerfectRAW system. It converts the raw images directly into TIFF files without altering the colors. Photoshop makes harmful color adjustments to raw files when it reads them directly, but it leaves TIFF files alone when it reads them in. Now let's read the TIFF files into Photoshop. Now we bring up ColorPerfect on the first file. We are in color pause mode, so we will need to check PerfectRAW. This image was taken with an Olympus camera, so first we need to set that. And from the list of cameras, model EPL1. This photo is of a twin leaf blossom, and the color looks pretty good. The highlights in the petals are clipped, and we will remove some of that with the highlight control. However, as is often the case, this image has more sparkle with a little clipping left in. Now we OK out. The next image is an hibiscus flower, but this image was taken with a Panasonic camera. Instead of going to the Panasonic list, we will use my cameras, a list of cameras I use regularly that I have pulled from the master list. There, the Panasonic GX1. Again, the color looks good. Camera is showing in the color balance area, which means that again we are using white balance recorded by the camera. Here, sunlight is hitting directly on the end of the long pistol stamen structure and causing some clipping. Let's right-click to select the stamen, and then zoom in on it. We can regain some of the detail using the highlight control. We could play with this more, but we will OK out. Next, we have a photo with dramatic clouds. A different camera again, this time a Canon 850IS, a pocket camera from a few years ago that has a physically large sensor. This camera has a marvelous hack that allows it to save raw images in DNG format. Select it from my cameras. This is an image which looked reasonable over a wide range of color balance. Unlike most raw conversions, PerfectRAW images are designed to have color integrity so that they are visually consistent and respond particularly well to situations like this. ColorPerfect has what we call gray click. Click a point on the image, and that point will be made the appropriate shade of gray, with all the colors of the image properly adjusted to follow. First, we click on a bright cloud area. Next, we click on a white building. But we can get a completely different effect by clicking a dark area in the clouds. Note how even this extreme change has a realistic look. Metal electric poles are normally a good gray, so I will gray-click one of those, and now we OK out. Finally, we have an image of my cat Splotch resting in a sunbeam. Again, the camera is the Olympus EPL1, but here we did not do a white balance, and the one the camera chose is off. We gray-click the white neck, and it is better. I'll save the current settings so we can return to them in a minute. Now I'll adjust the black control. Adding and removing black affects the highlights most. Removing black is the same as increasing the light level on the image. See how the highlights clip and lose detail. Adding black is the same as lowering the illumination on the image. The color tones of the image remain natural, but lighten or darken, same as changing the light level or the f-stop. Now I'll adjust the white control. This is quite different than black. When we add white to an image, it adds fog. So logically, when we remove white from the image, we will remove fog. The white control is basic to obtaining a good image, yet in most other systems, it is very difficult to do accurately. ColorPerfect provides quite an array of other controls that let the user adjust the image without sacrificing color integrity. Gamma and saturation are nearly as basic as black and white, and we can see what happens when I adjust those. Now I'll return to the settings I saved earlier, but I like the little extra depth in the shadows from removing some white. You can always use help to find out about a control. The first help message also tells you where you can find all the ColorPerfect help made into the form of a web page. Now, to get help on an individual item, just click it. Close the message box when you are finished. Now we OK out. And that concludes the PerfectRAW introduction.